here, along with Mary Alfaro Velasco and Jesús Martinez. We're here tonight in Casa con la Plaza.
Eso.
This is our weekly, almost daily series of programming direct from our homes, or in this case, Jose's studio, to you in your homes. If you're on your laptop, on your pad, on your mobile device, on your desktop, or wherever you happen to be, we're coming in live to share La Plaza's programming, what we normally do at La Plaza de Cultura y Artes, located conveniently across from Olvera Street on Main Street there in downtown LA, directly to you. So just to let you know what we're up to here, this is our fourth week. Can you believe it? Our fourth week of programming. And this is our first duet that we're presenting for you. We're two people in the room at the same time, and either Mary or Jesús will explain a little bit about that. But I just want to go ahead and introduce the two of them with brief bios. Mary Velasco, Mary Alfaro Velasco, raise your hand, please.
Presente.
She's a guitarist, singer, and music educator from San Fernando, performing diverse musical styles of the Américas, and enjoys reinterpreting classic boleros, rancheras, folk songs, and other song forms to celebrate the depth of female, queer, and Latinx identity. Guitarist and principal singer in Trio Romántico Voz Bohemia, and has performed and composed music for professional film, TV, and theater productions. Performances include several onstage performances at La Plaza de Cultura y Artes on our outdoor stage, along with Jesús. And let me tell you a little bit about Jesús here. He's a producer, an engineer, and requintista based in LA. Began playing the requinto at the age of 11 under his father's instruction. The requinto, do you have it there with you?
Aquí está, yeah.
Right aquí está, okay. It's a unique soprano guitar with Latin roots and classical background. He commenced his academic career at Berklee College of Music. In 2011, he became a member of Tres Souls. They've performed all over the LA area. And now they're playing out of Decibel Studios, focusing on recording and arranging regional music, Mexican music, as well as Latin guitar. So that's it for me for now. I'm going to disappear until later. I'll be checking comments. I'll be checking chats, Q&As. And if something comes up that needs immediate attention, I'll let them know. But for the most part, I'm going to stay out of the way and let the music speak for itself. Take it away.
All right. Thank you, Abelardo. So we have a few songs that we prepared. Couple that kind of speak to what we're all going through right now. You know, a lot of us, we can't be around all of our friends and loved ones, in the same place right now. And you know, that can be hard. And, you know, we're all in this together, and we thought to prepare a couple songs that kind of speak to what's going on, and also just other classics that we like performing. Jesús and I, we play in a trio, and then we also play as a duet. And these are kind of our favorite songs. So we're gonna start off with a classic bolero, the song written by María Grever, one of Mexico's great songwriters. So ahí les va. Nada de explicarte. beso que dejaste, ya no lo puedes dar. Cuando vuelva a tu lado y esté sola contigo, las cosas que te digo no repitas jamás por compasión. Une tu labio al mío y estrechame tus brazos y cuenta los latidos de nuestro corazón. Te digo, no repitas jamás por compasión. Une tu labio al mío y estrechame en tus brazos y cuenta los latidos de nuestro Cuando vuelva a tu lado, the name of that song, written by María Grever, and this song dedicated to all the folks that are in la cuarentena, that are quarantining, self-quarantining, away from their loved ones. I feel you. It's a interesting, unprecedented time. Y, you know, estamos lejos, o sea, no tan lejos de nuestros queridos, pero pues no poder estar con ellos ahí en el momento, en el mismo espacio. So, una canción para todos ustedes. So, cuando vuelvo a tu lado. And this next song is a bolerito, but it's a little, nice little pick-me-up. So, ahí si quieren bailar, you know, don't be shy. Ahí en su casa, no one's watching, right? So, ahí les va.
I'm the guy that doesn't know what's next.
I always forget to tell. Yeah. My bad.
Una de los panchos para ustedes, a classic Los Panchos. Maybe, all right, let's try this song out real quick. Ahí va.
Cuando y cómo y dónde, tú siempre me respondes, quizás, quizás, quizás. Y así pasan los días y yo voy desesperando y tú contestando, quizás, quizás, quizás. Estás perdiendo el tiempo pensando, pensando por lo que más tú quieras. Hasta cuándo, y así pasan los días y yo voy desesperando y tú contestando, quizás, quizás, quizás. Thank you.
y dónde. Tú siempre me respondes. Quizás, quizás, quizás. Y así pasan los días y yo voy desesperando. Y tú, tú contestando. Quizás, quizás, quizás. Estás perdiendo el tiempo pensando, pensando. Por lo que más tú quieras, ¿hasta cuándo? ¿Hasta cuándo? Y así pasan los días y yo voy desesperando. Y tú, tú contestando. Quizás, quizás, quizás. Quizás, 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 quizás.
Esa Mari.
Esa Chuy.
Unas clásicas para ustedes.
Eso, eso. One of our favorite songs. Una movidita. Hope you guys liked it. This song was also recorded in English. Sometimes we do a little Spanglish version, pero así la dejamos en español hoy. Y bueno, I'd like to talk a little bit more about like what we do, you know, like Abelardo said, we've performed at La Plaza before, we perform throughout LA, and we're involved with different, all kinds of different musical projects. This is Decibel Studios. This is where all the magic happens, mm-hmm. under the direction of Jesús Martinez. And he and I have, when did we meet? Like,
we met back in 1990. No, we met, I think, like 2015 or so.
Yeah.
Something 20, like that. Yeah.
2015 at
Guelaguetza. We were, I was playing with our other member, band member, Roberto Carlos.
Yeah.
At Guelaguetza, we're looking for a singer. And Roberto met Mary at La Plaza.
Yeah, La Plaza. So, yeah, he was DJing.
All of this is possible because of La Plaza in many ways.
Thank you.
And so we were playing at Guelaguetza, and that's how we met. And it was an instant friendship for sure. And she's a great musician. She's a great person. And I enjoy playing with her very much so.
Thank you. I paid him to say that. No, hey, but patrocinado por... No, but
go ahead. There's some messages. Let me go check in case it's something that we need to.
Yeah, we have our computers like kind of way down. In the studio. But yeah, we've been making music since 2015. A ver qué dice la gente.
Bienvenidos, everybody. Oh, so good. Oh yeah, it's just I'm speaking to
Abelardo.
Hello, it's me. And our Facebook live on La Plaza. I have a watch party going on my Facebook page and also on Latino LA's page. And we got quite a few comments. So I'll just read off. Yvonne Aguilera says, hermosos boleros.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Muchas gracias.
Here, let me go to change the view here. I might as well come on camera for a little while.
Yeah.
All right. I scared myself. Anyway. We have Lupe Ariola loves them. One of our board members. Thank you, Lupe. Bettina Chacon Molena loves it. Raquel Campos loved it. So let's keep on going. Jessica Howe, beautiful, she says. Elsa Velasco gives a big clap. Gloria Saldivar, beautiful song. And Jimena Martin. Hi, Mary.
Jimena.
And then we have over here, Rick, who is Willoughby's dad. Gives a shout out to Jesus.
Oh, what's up, Rick? How are you, brother? Thank you for tuning in.
All right. Well, I'm going to disappear one more time. Adelante.
Órale. A ver, ¿le entramos, Mari? ¿Con cuál? A ver.
Yeah. So this is a song that we've played together as a trio. And actually, our bandmate, Beto, as we like to call him, his brother, Pepe, is a requintista. He plays in La Santa Cecilia, and he's been, he started teaching me requinto romántico. I started a couple years ago with Jesus, with the generous support of a contract that they have every year for master artists to teach students. So I started off requinto under Chuy's instruction, and Pepe Carlos has been teaching me, he started teaching me recently. And one of the first songs that we're working on is called Cuando Llora Mi Guitarra. It was recorded by Julio Jaramillo, which is one of our absolute favorite, like, singers. And man, he just interprets boleros and waltzes so incredibly. And this is one of my personal favorites. And a ver si no sale. Ahí les va.
Cansada de llamarte, con mi alma destrozada, comprendo que no viene porque no quiere Dios. Y al ver que inútilmente tendí yo mis palabras, llorando mi guitarra se deja oír su voz. Y al ver que inútilmente tendí yo mis palabras, llorando mi guitarra se deja oír su voz. Llora guitarra porque eres mi voz de dolor. Grita de nuevo su nombre si no te escuchó. Y dile que aún la quiero, que aún espero que vuelva. Que si no viene mi amor no tiene consuelo. Que solitaria sin su cariño te muero. Guitarra, tú que interpretas en tu vibrar mi quebranto. Que recibes en tu madero mi llanto, llora conmigo si no la vieras volver.
Échale, Mari.
Cansada de llamarte, con mi alma destrozada. Comprendo que no viene porque no quiere Dios. Y al ver que inútilmente tendí yo mis palabras, llorando mi guitarra se deja oír su voz. Y al ver que inútilmente tendí yo mis palabras, llorando mi guitarra se deja oír su voz. Y ahora guitarra porque eres mi voz de dolor. Grita de nuevo su nombre, tú no te escuchó. Y dile que aún la quiero, que aún espero que vuelva. Que si no viene mi amor no tiene consuelo. Que solitaria sin su cariño me muero. Guitarra, tú que interpretas en tu vibrar mi quebranto. Que recibes en tu madero mi llanto.
Mary Alfaro, lead guitar, lead vocals.
Jesús Martinez en la guitarra también, cambiándole un poquito el instrumento.
Yeah, this instrument is called a guitar. Yeah, so this guitar, I'll tell you guys a little backstory on this guitar. This guitar was made by Pimentel, the Pimentel brothers. Their father made requintos and guitars for all of the famous trios from Los Tres Caballeros, Los Dandies, Los Tres Haces, Los Tres Reyes. All of them got requintos and guitars from the Pimentels. And this guitar was made, maybe about 3 years ago in Mexico, de Efe. And I love it.
Yeah, it's beautiful. I love playing on that guy.
Thank you.
I got this one at Sam Ash.
Hey, there we go.
but man, like as musicians, as artists right now, I know we're not able to go out, obviously, and we're like really buckling down on our music, and our guitars have become like our therapists, our babies, you know. They're always our babies, but I see, it's so cool to see a lot of our friends and other musicians that we follow that we're fans of, like putting out new music and just doing really, really awesome things with their craft. now that we're home and we're doing a lot of self-reflection too, you know, this going through this right now, like I'm definitely like, you know, thinking about things I haven't thought about or things that I want to do with music. And we're really happy to have this opportunity to perform. And yeah, we've had like, I think I didn't play for like 2 months. And the other day we had a social distancing trio gig, which was really fun.
Yeah.
And then this is the first time we've done a duet thing in a couple months.
Yeah.
It's fun. And then just FYI, Jesus and I, we did get tested for the Rona, as the kids are calling it. Right?
We're hashtag negative Rona.
Yeah. So
Rona
we
negative. Yeah.
Yeah, we got tested and we're negative, and you know, we've been good about just not going out so much. You know, my poor parents, they were up in the Bay Area for a while and they came down right before this happened, and we've been buckling down. Y ahí los estoy regañando por ir a la tienda and stuff, porque yo puedo ir por ellos, you know? So, it's a trip, but, you know, we're looking at the silver linings here and playing music for you guys.
Exactly.
So this next song is it's a huapango, and a lot of you guys might know it. Sing along if you recognize it.
I'm just going to change one little thing, some little technical things, and okay.
Tune up.
Yeah, we do have a question here of Mary and Jesus from Esperanza Sanchez. I think you know who she is.
Yes.
What inspired you both to focus on boleros, rancheras, huapangos, and other songs of the Americas?
That's a good question.
Go for it, Mary, and I'll answer a second.
Well, I think my personal journey, like when I was in high school, I heard for the first time the album Canciones de mi Padre that Linda Ronstadt put out. She put out, I think, two records of Canciones de mi Padre. One is the first one, and then the other one was Más Canciones. When I heard that record, man, I heard La Cigarra, and I just like felt, I just wanted to learn more about this music. I mean, my parents are from Mexico. They came to LA as teenagers. They met here. I was born and raised in LA. And I heard mariachis, you know, growing up at, you know, parties when I would go down to Aguascalientes. And a lot of times we'd go in summer times, and my grandma's birthday was in the summer, so they would bring her mariachis. And I don't know, just like, but it wasn't really a big part of my life. And then I heard that album, and man, I just like fell in love with ranchera music. And at that time I wanted to learn guitar. I was a clarinetist. I was like in marching band and did the whole thing. Nice. But I really wanted to learn guitar and learn more about myself, about my heritage. Back when CDs were the main like way that we listened to music, I bought a Los Pancho CD, and I like listened to that on repeat. When I went to Santa Monica College, and I would commute from like the Valley down to SMC, and I would listen to that, those two albums a lot, the Los Panchos and the Linda Ronstadt. And then from there, I just started listening to more and more. But it wasn't until I met Roberto, Carlos, and Jesus that I que le entré a esta onda. And I just fell in love even more with this genre of music. It's just so beautiful. The poetry, the chord progressions, the feeling, the fact that bolero music is in almost every country in Latin America and the U.S. I mean, Los Panchos were based out of what, New York City?
Yeah, they met in New York City. Fun fact.
Yeah. True. So it's just such a cool, beautiful music that I find really just inspiring. So that's my long story.
For me, I began to listen to the music because my dad also plays bolero music. My dad plays requinto, and this requinto actually that I'm playing today was designed for him, Candela's Guitars here in Boyle Heights, by the father of the cat who's running it now. Can't remember. I think Don Candelario, I think, was his name, if I'm not mistaken. And so my dad, as I was a kid, I would see him play at like family parties, but he would always listen to music, and he definitely listened to a lot of boleros. And I always remember it being such beautiful music. And I always just really enjoyed it. I think one of the first songs that I ever remember listening to is Poquita Fe by Los Tres Reyes. And so, you know, that was my first music education really digesting all that music. And I thank my pops for that. Like, I would go work with him in summers, and he would have these tapes, bolero tapes, and we would just listen through it while, you know, we were working throughout LA. My dad's a gardener, so we would go work in the gardens. And it was really cool because there'd be certain words that were like too big for me to understand. So I'd be like, hey, Dad, what does this mean? And he would break it down to me. And, you know, that made me fall in love even more with the music. So when I began to want to play guitar, I asked him to teach me, and he started to teach me to play requinto because that's what he knew. But I was always open to it because I already loved the music, and it was like a snowball effect. I began to play, and I just became super obsessed with playing requinto as a kid. And I never performed as a kid or anything. Like, I mean, I would play with my dad like at family parties, but I never like joined the trio until I was 22. But I would just play for myself, you know, and try to get better for myself because I really enjoyed it. And then, you know, I met the trio, which I'm in, Tres Sols, met them, and we started to play. I met Mary in 2015, and we began Voz Bohemia, and yeah, it's kind of how it happened.
Yeah, we've had fun journeys for sure. And thank you for the question. And a big shout out to Esperanza. We used to work together at La Plaza. I believe Esperanza's still there. She's handling the curatorial department right now, preparing some exhibitions. So a big shout out to the staff at La Plaza, to Esperanza, and saludos a todos. So yeah. So ahí les va otra rolita, el huapanguito. So here we go.
Malagueña.
Alfaro, wow. Somero.
Muchas gracias. Thank you guys. Malagueña, or as we like to call it, Malagreña.
Malagreña. AKA me. Chale. I need a haircut.
Oh my gosh, me too.
I look like I got a helmet on the back of my head. Safety first.
Yeah, I'm like, I'm going a little nuts. Sometimes like me pongo trenzas just to like get it out of my face. I look like, yeah, it's crazy. I just look like a little kid. But yeah, Malagueña, the name of that song. We're going to switch it up a tiny bit. And this song is by one of our favorite bands. Definitely one of my personal favorite bands. They're based out of Ciudad de Mexico, Mexico City. And let's go. You recognize it? Sing along.
Clásicas.
Se llama María, the name of that song. One of our favorite Café Tacuba songs. A lot of us have had a lot of time to check out, you know, new music that people are putting out, and also just some classic stuff. Me personally, I've been listening to, if you guys haven't heard it, there's like the Richie Valens live concert at Pacoima Middle School. Ooh. Yeah, check it out. It's so cool.
Hmm.
Yeah, it's dope. Amazing. He's just like rocking all the way through all these songs. It's so, so cool. So Richie Valens, un paisita, he's a fellow Mexican American from the Valley. He was from Pacoima, and we really like this song that he wrote.
So. I'll grab the electric guitar.
Oh yeah, that's right. We're gonna switch it up a little bit. Abelardo, if you see any questions or comments you want to let us know about,
by all means. Yeah, let's see. Bettina Chacon Molano says, I am drinking a beer, Pacifico, and eating chicharrones. It's so appropriate.
Yes.
We have, let's see, Ana Caringela saying, wow, what a great voice.
Oh, thank you.
She is great. Boleros, hope all is good with you and the familia. Love your style of playing the boleros. So we're getting a lot of Facebook live action.
Orale.
So keep it coming. And then Henrietta Hurtado just said, ceviche. That's all she says, ceviche. So with that, getting me hungry too. All right.
Well, thank you everybody for joining and for singing along and grooving and having a little beer. That's what's up. So, ahí les va.
Not too loud.
yes, we belong together. All eternity.
So. It's all these.
Just grooving, you know. One of our favorite English jams. I like to mix it up every now and then. So.
Yeah. So. I'm grabbing the quinto again.
I got it.
Excuse me, guys.
So, Jesus, what have you been up to during this lockdown situation?
I have been anxious.
Me too.
No, it's been honestly, it's been hard on me. I'm sure it's been hard on a lot of people, but it's nice to be able to have the space like La Plaza has given us to play for you all, and it's therapeutic for sure. But I have been still working on music. This is my studio, and I arrange music for different artists. I record different artists, engineer, mix. So I've been doing some of that. And I also have been working on adding different tones to bolero music. I just bought a Rhodes keyboard, an electrical piano from the 70s. And they usually use it in like a lot of R&B. It's been used. It's used in a lot of different genres, but the main ones like R&B and soul. And I've always been a big fan of that music. So yeah, I've been experimenting a little bit on different harmonies and stacking vocals, like more of an R&B style, but for bolero music. And yeah, I just have these like crazy ideas sometimes that I want to try out, and sometimes they work, sometimes they don't, but that's what I've been doing. I also am going to start doing requinto lessons, free requinto lessons through YouTube, and then we're going to meet once a month through Zoom, and you can follow me, Decibel Studios LA on Instagram, and I'll be putting all the information up there. So if you guys are interested in learning requinto, I will be giving free lessons. The first video, or the second video actually, is going to be this Friday. So.
Oh, yeah. How exciting.
Yeah. What about yourself, Mary?
I'll be there.
Yeah.
Yeah, and Jesus is an amazing teacher, let me tell you. So, knowledgeable, patient, understanding, all those good things. So, yeah, and musicos out there, if you guys need, like, you know, a place to record or a producer, Jesus really knows what he's talking about. So
thank you,
right before the lockdown, we had recorded a couple songs, and so we still have to finish them, just kind of like a personal project, but can't wait.
That was a lot of fun for sure.
We got some things in the works.
But
it's like our lives have totally been like kind of turned upside down right now, and you know, a lot of you guys are feeling it, and so we really empathize. Me personally, just, you know, like still involved in music projects. We did the master apprenticeship program with Alliance for California Traditional Arts, and I'm employed through them part time. I think this is like the third year now where a teaching partner, Lorenzo Martinez, who's amazing. He's
beast.
Yeah, he's a beast. He's
a beast.
He is like just a really important figure in the Chicano sound here in LA. And sometimes he plays with us. And so he and I teach at a prison out in Blythe, near the Arizona border. And obviously prisons, you know, they're not allowing visitors to come in, so that they're not compromising the health of the inmates. And so what we've been doing is we've been preparing like packets for them, like music theory, kind of like info sheets on Mexican composers, Chicano musicians, et cetera. And so we've been doing that. And then we're also gonna start working on some videos that they're going to air in like the prison channel throughout the state. So, and Quetzal Flores, who has really, started the program, the Arts and Corrections program with ACTA. He's saying, like, you know, we're just going to bombard them with like cultural, like information, like culture. And so we're looking forward to working on things like that. And it's looking like Jesus and I are going to work together too in the fall.
Yeah. It seems that.
Fingers crossed.
Yeah. Arts and Corrections, I'm coming your way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we're excited about that. But I've been doing that. And I started a job in the middle of all this at UCLA with the UCLA Library, working with the Center for Oral History, specifically on a project to document the stories of mariachis in Los Angeles. And since, you know, we can't really be out and about right now, what we're gonna start off with is documenting mariachis and talking about the recent issues with mariachi music in LA, and also how the pandemic is affecting musicians, which is like, it's affecting them so much. So working on those things and trying out new music. If nobody has questions right now or comments, we're gonna jump into a song that we recorded actually with Jesus produced it, and we recorded with Abraham Hernandez, who's an amazing pianist, like absolutely amazing. And he takes out these arrangements of ranchera music and like polkas on the piano, and is just absolutely amazing, like norteño jams.
Norteño, but then he makes it classic. He's a beast.
He's awesome. So check him out.
Abraham Hernandez.
I can't remember his Instagram handle right now.
Piano.
Piano Sola.
Algo así. I'm actually going to be recording him tomorrow.
So oh, nice. Oh,
I am going to get a treat tomorrow to hear his arrangements. And I'm going to go record with him. So it's going to be fun.
Yeah. So we recorded this song with Abraham, but we decided to try something out with guitar, with requinto, and this next song was written by Silvio Rodríguez, who is from Cuba, and he really started his career or became more well known right after the Cuban Revolution, and he wrote this song to talk about the hope that the Cuban people were feeling for like a new chapter in the history of Cuba. You know, obviously it was run by, you know, dictators before then, and you know, it still has its problems, but Silvio Rodríguez is just an incredible, incredible songwriter and singer and guitarist, and I really love the song. This song kind of helped me get through like kind of like a tough moment in my life, and it talks about hope. So I hope that we're all feeling hopeful that we're going to get through this, and we dedicate the song to just everybody. I miss one.
Do you want me to do an electric or a guitar?
Lo que tú quieras, whichever.
I might as well get the electric. Huh?
I got one. And we agreed to this like yesterday, I think.
Yeah.
And we jammed on it today, so we're excited to give it a shot.
All right, I'm butting in for a little while here. We got a couple. We got about 10 minutes to go, so not trying to rush you, but we have after a couple more songs, and then we'll get to some comments. We have a couple questions here, but keep it coming. It's beautiful. I'm enjoying it here.
Thank you. Thank Gracias. You so much. So, ahí les va. This song is called "Rabo de Nube," and "Rabo de Nube" in the Cuban people. The country folk, they call a rabo de nube a tale of a tornado. So this song talks about a tornado taking all away the bad stuff and leaving us with hope. So I know that.
Si me dijeran, pide un deseo. Preferiría un rabo de nube. Un torbellino en el suelo y un gran ira que sube. Marrador de tristeza, un aguacero en venganza, que cuando escampe parezca nuestra esperanza. Un marredor de tristeza, un aguacero en venganza, que cuando escampe parezca nuestra esperanza.
Something we're trying out.
Sorry, guys, for all my mistakes.
Nah, I was
trying to read off.
Something we're trying out, and yeah, we've been having fun with new songs, and with this next song, nos despedimos with this con esta próxima canción. We say our farewells, and it's also a song that we I think just tried today.
So, yeah.
But it really speaks to the moment that we're living in right now. So this song is dedicated to, again, those of you that are far away from your loved ones. We're on the same boat, and we know it's hard, but we hope listening to or singing along to the song kind of helps get that, get it out. So.
Una canción de Los Tres Haces, one of my personal favorites.
Yeah. A ver.
Apartarte de mí, el mundo parece distinto cuando no estás junto a mí. Thank you. que tomas unas tú. Ni yo quiero escucharla si no la escuchas tú. Es que te has convertido en parte de mi alma. Ya nada me conforma si no estás tú también. Más allá de tus labios, del sol, de las estrellas,
siete puntos. All right.
Contigo en la distancia.
Thank you so much. We got a lot of applause going on here. Little clapping hands.
Thank you.
We have,
thanks, Mom.
Muchos likes, muchos loves. Such beautiful boleros. This is, thank you for the great music, says Yolanda Virgin. Qué bonito, says Denise Beltran. Tiene una voz de ángel. We have people shouting out to the Arts and Corrections program. She's a teacher. Denise Beltran is she's be interested in participating, a teacher and musician in the Imperial Valley near Blythe.
Órale.
Roberto Martinez comments that Lencho is an amazing musician. Thanks for sharing with the folks who are in the prisons.
Thank you. Yeah, we really owe a lot to Larry, as we call him. He's amazing. He's not on the social media, but if you guys want to catch us, you know, we play with different folks all the time. So you can follow me at Mary Alfaro Velasco on Instagram, and then
me, you can find me at Decibel Studios LA on Instagram.
Yeah, so we always post where we're playing and who we're bringing along, and yeah, we hope to meet you guys. For those of you guys that we haven't met in person, we hope to meet you guys in the near future.
And we do have a question here. Jaime Diaz wants to learn how to play the saxophone. Who do you recommend for the sax?
Lorenzo Martinez. He knows how to play everything.
All right.
Yeah.
We'll get him in touch. Jaime, we'll get you in touch with him.
Yeah, please.
All right. Well, I really want to thank you both for this beautiful concert at home in Casa con la Plaza. I mean, my heart is breaking here with all the beautiful songs you sang. And with that, I'd like to thank our audience out there in Zoom, Zoomlandia, as Dan Guerrero calls it, and also Facebook Live, Facebooklandia.
Yeah.
And I'd like to just tell you what's coming up next. We have for the next session, this Friday night, May 22nd at 7 p.m., I don't know. I know we all need some motivation. We all need some inspiration. We have Ernie G, an empowerment comedian. He's going to be advancing his inspirational message of self-empowerment and purpose this Friday in a program we call Let Your Light Shine with Ernie G. So that's Friday at 7 p.m. On we're going to take Monday off. It's Memorial Day. So we're going to give a little respect to the people that passed away, that gave the ultimate sacrifice for this great country on Memorial Day. So we're going to take the day off ourselves. But starting on Wednesday, we have Claudia Puig, who's the president of the LA Film Critics Association, a notable journalist, critic. She's going to be talking about surviving COVID-19 with TV, which has been a lifesaver for many of us. And then next Friday, we have Dan Guerrero. He's coming back with his own show. If you don't know Dan, he's Lalo Guerrero's son, an activist, an entertainer. It's Dan Guerrero's happy hour with guest Richard Montoya of Culture Clash, a writer, a director, an actor. So that's next Friday at 7 p.m. But you could catch all this information on our website, lapca.org, lapca.org. Also on our Facebook page, at La Plaza LA. We post, we're recording this, so this video will be on our website. We archive all our videos, all our Zoom sessions, en casa, from our casa to your casa, so you could catch up with Lalo Alcaraz, with Gustavo Arellano, cooking demonstrations coming up that we've had already, learning how to make flour tortillas. Yesterday, Tirsa from Tirsa's Cafe taught us how to make Mexican rice and cilantro lime rice. A whole lot of stuff. Our community is so talented, so inspirational. And you both have been inspirational tonight. And hope to see you soon after this is all over. But for now, we'll catch up with what you're doing on your Instagram page, on your Facebook page, and here at La Plaza also. So, buenas noches a todos. Anything else? Last words, Mary, Jesus.
Just thank you. And thank you to Chuy for like making this happen with the mics and all the technology. Te avientas. Thank you, Jesus.
Yeah, thank you very much, everybody. Abelardo, everybody at La Plaza, yes, for inviting us. We truly appreciate it. And you know, especially in these times when we don't have mm-hmm. gigs, this is awesome and beautiful. So we appreciate it very much.
Yeah, it's a big
all right. Well, thank you. And last, our sponsors for the night, for this series, Walmart and AARP California. Thanks to you. And thanks to all the staff at La Plaza who are behind this. I'm the one who happens to be in front of this little camera, but we got John, we got all our curatorial staff, our programming staff. Jimena has been instrumental in putting this together. So we'll catch you all soon. Buenas noches. Ahí te guacho.
Stay safe, everybody.
Bye-bye. Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.